In the simplest terms, a light went out in the world today, yet somehow leaves it brighter for having burned, and richer, and more soulful, and more serene. Aretha Franklin, she died today at 76. Her voice could soar to the heavens and raise us up there with it. That was a miracle, but it wasn't her only one. So was her life's journey and how it became the soundtrack to moments that changed us all, whether on the national stage or even on a local dance floor with someone we love. In a moment, two people who knew her well and loved her. First, let's hear from 360's Randy King.
Aretha Franklin.
Long before she became the Queen of Soul, she was born Aretha Louise Franklin in Memphis, Tennessee. Her mother was a gospel singer and pianist, her father a pastor. He raised Aretha in Detroit after her parents split up. Aretha Franklin demanded respect from an early age. She taught herself to play piano before age 10. Her first performances were at her father's church.
My dad encouraged me to sing. I really didn't want to sing in front of a lot of people. And he just kept pushing me out there anyway. Oh, come on, Rhea, I want you to sing now, come on. And okay, all right, Dad. And they would put a box like this box right here, small box, behind the pulpit, and I would stand on that box and sing.
By age 12, she was touring with her father, whose sermons reportedly earned him a reputation as the man with the golden voice, a trait he seems to have passed on to his daughter.
Baby, here I am, on railroad tracks.
In 1964, Aretha made one of her first television appearances on the Steve Allen Show. Still a newcomer, she performed the song Won't Be Long.
And it won't be long.
It was her song, Respect, though, an Otis Redding original she recorded back in 1967, that catapulted the 25-year-old into stardom.
R-E-S-P-C-T.
It surged to number one and earned Aretha her first two Grammy Awards for Best R&B Recording Artist and Best Solo Female R&B Performance. For women, it became an anthem. But it also changed history when the Civil Rights Movement adopted it as their mantra.
Change, change, change.
Aretha was barely in her 20s by the time the world recognized her as the Queen of Soul, but she was just getting started. Her recording career would go to span more than half a century and go far beyond soul music. Her roots were in gospel, but Aretha also thrilled audiences with jazz, opera, and R&B.
You're no good.
Her songs were personal, with not-so-hidden messages about pain and loss, also sensuality and sexuality. Her song, Think, written near the end of her first marriage, was a rallying cry for women fed up with lousy men. Aretha won 18 Grammy Awards, including Best Female R&B Performance for 8 years in a row. At the peak of her career in the 60s and 70s, she had more than two dozen top 40 hits. In 1987, Aretha was the first woman inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Long before that, in 1968, she sang at Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s funeral.
And the wind blew.
Also at inauguration concerts for Jimmy Carter in 1977 and Bill Clinton in 1993. She sang at Rosa Parks' funeral in 2005.
We want to thank you for her wavering.
And in 2009, at the inauguration of Barack Obama.
Yeah, 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 queen.
I was delighted and thrilled to be there, and that was the most important thing, not so much my performance.
Later, in 2015, she brought the president to tears at the Kennedy Center honors. Earlier that year, she performed for Pope Francis in Philadelphia. Over the years, there were cameos on Murphy Brown. Unforgettable performances with the likes of Smokey Robinson, Rod Stewart, and Elton John. And duets with James Brown. In February 2017, Aretha announced she would stop touring, but her music will live on.
He joins us now from outside the Apollo Theater in Harlem, where you hear there's a party going on in honor of Aretha Franklin. Randy, I know you've been sitting there watching this. It's really a sample of what's been going on across the country today.
Well, Jim, this is a very special place for Aretha Franklin fans and certainly for Aretha Franklin. She first performed here at the Apollo Theater back in 1962 when she was just 19 years old. So they've been blasting her music here in the streets outside the Apollo Theater. And if you take a look at the marquee, you can see it's been changed. It says, "Rest in peace, Aretha Franklin." They've been saying the Queen of Soul. They've been giving her her dates all day long. And people are continuing just to dance in the street and enjoy her and honor her and remember her. But it's not just the people who are here in the street. Former presidents and the current president also were remembering her today. President Obama and Mrs. Obama released a statement saying, "In her voice, we could feel our history, all of it, and in every shade, our power, our pain, our darkness, our light, our quest for redemption, and our hard-won respect. She helped us feel more connected to each other, more hopeful, more human." The Clintons and President Trump as well released statements honoring the Queen of Soul. Jim, back to you.
Randy, thanks so much out there outside the Apollo Theater.